In this Blender tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can quickly make a camera follow a path. That way the camera tracks along a path, just like a nice dolly shot, and then follows the object on screen. So how do we get a camera to follow a path in Blender? First, let's set up our scene. So here I have a simple scene inside Blender with an animal. I have a few lights and I have a camera. There's a few things we can do to make our animation of cameras inside Blender easier. The first thing is to right-click at the top of the screen and then do a vertical split. I'll select somewhere in the middle, and then over on the left-hand side, I'll select View, Cameras, Active Camera. Then to make this screen a bit bigger so I can see the camera better inside Blender, I'll select View, Cameras, Frame Camera Bounds. This is looking great already, but what I can do is make sure I have the camera selected over here in the scene, then select the camera down here on the bottom right, scroll down to Viewport Display, make sure it's twirled out, and then I can change Pass Part Out, and then this will darken the background. That way I can focus more on what's happening. I can even focus more by changing the overlays. So here I have these overlays, and I can change this one so I don't see it, as well as this one. Now I can really focus in on my scene. So now if I come over to the right-hand side of the screen in Blender, press G to grab the camera, and move the camera around, I get a nice sense of what's happening over on the left-hand side. But how do we get the camera to aim at an object? Well, that's as simple as selecting the camera in Blender, going to the constraints, then adding an object constraint to the camera. This time I'm going to do a track to. It gives me an option for a target. I'll select this eyedropper and select the target. I could also select this and select different items. So now if I press G and I move the camera, you can see that no matter where I put the camera, it tracks that object. This is great, but it can be limiting because I can't choose which part of the object the camera tracks inside Blender. To do that, I need to create an empty and use that as the target. So I'll press Shift A, come down here to Empty, and I'm going to make a sphere. I can rename this sphere to Camera Target. Then if I select the camera, I can come down here and delete the model and then select Camera Target. Now I can select the target, press G, move it, say, to the eye right here, and then I select the camera, and if I press G, notice that now it just goes along the eye. So no matter what, it's framing the eye of the figure. So that's pretty cool. And I can animate this empty so I can have it pass around different places, and the camera is always going to look in that direction. But then how do I get the camera to follow a nice curve around this circle? Well, to do that, we need to have a path for the camera to follow inside Blender. To add a path in Blender, press Shift A, go up to Curve, and then select Path. Press G, then Z to move the path up. I'm going to select Z right here, so I'm looking straight down. Then I'll tab into Edit Mode. I'll select this vertex, press X to delete it. Select this vertex, X to delete it. Then I'm going to grab the center vertex, G, Shift Z to keep it in the Z plane. I'll select this one, G, Shift, Z, and I'll move it, say, over here somewhere, and I'll select this one, G, Shift, Z, and put it over here, and then maybe I'll move this one back just a little bit, G, Shift, Z. Okay, and of course, I could select all of these, and I can press G, Z, and move them down. So now I have this path for my camera to follow, but how do I get it to follow? So I'm going to press Tab to go back to Object Mode, select the camera, and down in Constraints, I'm going to add a new constraint. This time, I'm going to add a Follow Path constraint to the camera inside Blender. It doesn't have anything to follow. What I need to do is select the target under Follow Path, and then select the curve. Right away, we can see that it is following the curve. But how do I get it to move along it? We'll use the offset of the Follow Path command. So I move this offset, but that really isn't working how I expect. It's very important to follow the blue line. So you see how this blue line is here? That's the part of the path that the camera is attracted to. It's very easy to think that you can put this part of the camera anywhere on the curve, but it has to be where this blue part is. So how do we do that? Select the curve, tab into Edit Mode, select the vertex that the blue line is going to, press Shift S, then cursor to select it. Tab out of Edit Mode, select the camera, then press Shift S, selection the cursor. So now the camera is on there, but wait. Now, if you look on the left-hand side of the screen, everything's messed up. Well, that's because we have to change the order. So I'm going to twirl up track 2 and drag track 2 right below the follow path. Now, the follow path command shows that this moves along the path. Pretty cool. But how do I get the path to start over here? Well, I need to offset to negative 100. So if I go to frame 0, and then I offset my path by negative 100, if I click right here, this will add a keyframe. Then I can move down to, say, frame 209 or 210, and I can type in 0, and then I can select this again to add a keyframe. So now if I drag my playhead, you'll see that I have this animation. I can press play, and we can see that very nicely. Problem is that this has that ease in and ease out. Often, ease in and ease out is really great, but sometimes with tracking camera motions, we want it to be a steady shot. So right now, I have both these keyframes selected in the bottom. I can press T for interpolation, and I can make it linear. So now, I should have this nice linear interpolation of the camera shot. So now that I have linear interpolation, we can change a few more things. So right now, I have this camera on 60 frames per second for a smooth animation, but sometimes the curve isn't smooth enough. So if you select on the curve, then select this right here, we can change the resolution. If I lower this, you can see it gets real chunky and looks dun 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 strange. But I can raise this up to 64, and then I get a much smoother animation. I can also click on the camera itself, and instead of 50 millimeters, I can make this 30. So that way I can get a bit closer, and then I can edit this curve. So if I select this curve, I press tab, and then I press G, Shift Z, and I move this in. And then I press G, Shift Z, and I move this part of the curve in, and then G, Shift Z, and move this part of the curve in. Now I can have this whipping shot. And what's nice is I can go ahead and select the camera again, tab out, select the camera, move to the first keyframe, and then I can just frame this shot by selecting the nerves curb, tabbing into edit mode, G, Shift, Z, moving this around. And I can even press G, Z, move up and down. So I can start here, and then as I move along, right here, I can go ahead and G, Shift, Z, decide which way I want that to be. So something like this. And then I can move all the way to the end and see how I want that to end. So right here, maybe G, Shift, Z. I want to move in a little bit closer to the object. So hopefully this allows you to move your camera around on a path in Blender. Happy 3D modeling.